Win with call credit spreads when stocks fall. The stock market goes up more than it goes down, but it does go down, and sometimes one of your favorite stocks will keep sinking and sinking, and the outlook for a near-term recovery may not be good. Traders can bet on a stock price falling in a number of ways, such as by shorting the stock if they have the available cash in their trading account, or by buying a put option. Another strategy which offers less risk is a bear call credit spread. This strategy takes advantage of the time decay characteristic of options, and puts time on your side. With bear call credit spreads, you also receive cash into your account immediately upon entering the trade. The bear call credit spread is used when the outlook on the underlying stock is neutral to bearish. To learn more, continue watching, but first, please take a moment to like our video and subscribe to our channel. This video assumes you have a basic understanding of options and option terminology. For more background on options, check out other videos and books on beginning options trading. As you can guess from its name, a bear call credit spread uses call options configured such that the trade results in a cash credit on entry. A bear call credit spread is constructed using two call options, one being purchased and one being sold. The strike price of the short call is placed below the strike price of the long call. Therefore, the trade will generate a net cash flow, net credit, when the trade is entered. The short call generates income and the long call limits the upside risk, should the stock price turn against you. Maximum profit will be realized if the stock price stays below the lower strike price, the short call, so that both options expire worthless at expiration, and the investor pockets the full net credit. Ideally, choose an expiration date between 20 and 60 days out, but not outside of this range. Let's look at a real example to see how a trade is set up. As of this writing, Plantear Technologies has been on a downtrend for quite a while, and continues to drop. It is currently trading at $19.75. First, we'll select an expiration date of about a month from now. Picking a strike price above the current stock price for the short call, we'll choose $22. We want to position our short strike price to be well above the current stock price to account for the stock moving slightly against you. Selling this call option pays us a premium of 81 cents, which, when multiplied by 100 because one option contract represents 100 shares of stock, gives us $81. Next, we pick a strike price for the long call, which will be higher than the short strike. We'll go with the $25 strike, which has a premium cost of 35 cents per share, or $35. Subtracting the $35 cost to buy the long call from the $81 credit we receive for the short call, gives us a net credit of $46. We selected these two strike prices because they both have a high option liquidity, that is well in the hundreds. Option spreads must have highly liquid options in order to be successful. This ensures that you can buy and sell easily. Bear call credit spreads have an estimated 70% probability of success. You want to select a short call strike price that the stock price will hopefully never reach. If the stock continues to go down, we win and get to keep the full $46. If the stock goes sideways, we win. If it goes up a little, we will still see some profit, or in the worst case, break even. Only if the stock price goes up beyond the short call strike price will we lose money. The amount of money we lose is capped, and we can calculate the maximum loss, before we even enter the trade, so we know our maximum risk going into the trade. The maximum profit is the net credit we receive from the trade, namely 46 cents times 100, or $46 in our example. The maximum potential profit is realized if the stock price is at or below the short call strike price at expiration. The maximum loss is the difference between the two strike prices minus the credit received, times 100. In our example, the difference between the strike prices is $25 minus $22, or $3. Then, $3 minus the 46 cent credit is $2.54, and times that by the option multiplier of 100. The maximum loss is $254. So, our downside risk is limited, no matter where the stock price is at expiration. The break-even point at expiration is the short strike price plus the net credit, which is $22 plus 46 cents, or $22.46. There is a risk of early assignment, and while possible at any time, generally will only occur at expiration if the short option is in the money. If you have guessed the wrong direction on the movement of the stock, close the spread out early. It is recommended that option spreads be closed before expiration. Not much can be gained in the last few days by holding on to the trade, but the longer a position is held, the more risk there is that the stock could move against you. Therefore, exit when a profit of 50% of the maximum gain is reached. Exit when the stock price begins to move against you to preserve as much capital as you can. Vertical option spreads, such as the bear call credit spread, are fairly easy to learn, and although they limit the amount of profit that can be made on a trade, they also cap the amount that can be lost, thus reducing risk. Also, they have a high probability of success.